It was so well timed, the interview, and it's critically important. I think back to the last earnings call where Zuckerberg basically said, we think Meta could be the world's leading AI company, but he's coming from behind a little bit. You did some catching up with him in that conversation.
Absolutely. And, you know, the scale of Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp is incredible. So Meta AI, their chatbot, is already embedded across all of those products and Oculus as well. And you can use it as a standalone chatbot. But he says hundreds of millions of people are going to be using this by the end of the year. In fact, before the end of the year, which he believes would make it the most used chatbot in the world. So in just a few months, it's, you know, potentially going to be eclipsing ChatGPT. Now, we talked a little bit about the level of intelligence of these latest models, and he admits he still believes there's a gap between Llama 3.1 and the most advanced models out there, but they're already working on Llama 4, and he says they're closing that gap when that update comes out.
Emily, as you were mentioning in what he termed a loaded question, but look, he's used to criticism. But there's been a lot of criticism about the fact that this is open source and the quote-unquote danger that that brings. How is he responding to that element of things?
Look, I think broadly, and this is what he's been saying now for many months, open source is more safe, is more secure. You've got all of these people around the world building on it, using it. If they see something wrong, Meta is going to get called out on it, he said, and we'll fix it. And the question is, though, what's in it for Meta? It's not that there's nothing in this for them. If the industry builds on this and it becomes an industry standard, then Meta has more sway in how the industry evolves. So he's saying, look, this is more safe, this is more secure, but yes, this is also better for us. In fact, he believes it's safer than the closed sources approaches of OpenAI or Google, because what's happening under the hood there, you can't necessarily see when something goes wrong. And what's really interesting is, you know, without open source, he says, I couldn't have built Facebook. This is a deep-seated part of his philosophy that he's had for 20 years. It's definitely interesting. He understands why there's been pushback, why some people see him as this sort of unlikely champion of open source, given how Meta and Facebook and its platforms have evolved, but he really doubled down that this is the best way forward.
There is Mark Zuckerberg, the gold chain wearing, new haircut, MMA fighting man. And then there is Mark Zuckerberg at the helm of a critically important company. Mm-hmm. You spent time with him at his home in Tahoe.
I did.
What did you learn about either of those characters?
I learned how they relate to each other.
Okay.
And, you know, he just seems... You know, I've met him many times over the years. I've interviewed him before. He just seems more comfortable in his own skin than I've ever seen. He also taught me how to wake surf. You know, Zuck has all these side quests. Wake surfing is one of them. And, you know, we talked about how he just has so much energy. These things keep him focused. Priscilla, his wife, was there as well. She's like, I prefer when he's doing all these other things because he just has so much energy to burn off. But my main takeaway was that he's not going anywhere. If you think about Jeff Bezos, who left Amazon, Larry and Sergey, who left Google, there are all these major tech founders who have since stepped back from their companies. Mark Zuckerberg isn't going anywhere. He said, look, I want to see this AI wave play out. You know, it's 10 or 15 more years before the next platform is going to emerge, and I'm going to be around for that.